I with us. I do not have any special announcements for this morning, obviously. Most of you probably know this is our last Sunday. I will also be doing Bible class this morning and kind of finishing up our discussion from last week. So with that, we will begin with the first reading.
Confession, I, by virtue of my office as a called and ordained servant of the word,
announce the grace of God unto all of you. And in this den, and by the command of my Lord Jesus Christ, I forgive you all your sins, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
You open your heart, you satisfy the desire of every living thing.
The Old Testament reading for the 11th Sunday after Pentecost is from 1 Kings chapter 19. Ahab told Jezebel all that Elijah had done and how he had killed all the prophets with the sword. Then Jezebel sent a messenger to Elijah, saying, "So may the gods do to me, and more also, if I do not make your life as the life of one of them by this time tomorrow." Then he was afraid, and he arose and ran for his life and came to Beersheba, which belongs to Judah, and left his servant there. But he himself went a day's journey into the wilderness and came and sat down under a broom tree. And he asked that he might die, saying, "It is enough. Now, O Lord, take away my life, for I am no better than my father's." And he lay down and slept under a broom tree. And behold, an angel touched him and said to him, "Arise and eat." And he looked, and behold, there was at his head a cake baked on hot stones and a jar of water. And he ate and drank and lay down again. And the angel of the Lord came again a second time and touched him and said, "Arise and eat, for the journey is too great for you." And he arose and ate and drank and went in the strength of that food 40 days and 40 nights to Horeb, the mount of God. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The epistle is from Ephesians chapters 4 and 5. This I say and testify in the Lord, that you must no longer walk as the Gentiles do, in the futility of their minds. They are darkened in their understanding, alienated from the life of God because of the ignorance that is in them, due to their hardness of heart. They have become callous and have given themselves up to sensuality, greedy to practice every kind of impurity. That is not the way you learned Christ, assuming that you have heard about him and were taught in him, as the truth is in Jesus, to put off your old self, which belongs to your former manner of life and is corrupt through deceitful desires, and to be renewed in the spirit of your minds, and to put on the new self, created after the likeness of God in true righteousness and holiness. Therefore, having put away falsehood, let each one of you speak the truth with his neighbor, for we are members one of another. Be angry and do not sin. Do not let the sun go down on your anger, and give no opportunity to the devil. Let the thief no longer steal, but rather let him labor, doing honest work with his own hands, so that he may have something to share with anyone in need. Let no corrupting talk come out of your mouths, but only such as is good for building up, as fits the occasion, that it may give grace to those who hear. And do not grieve the Holy Spirit of God, by whom you were sealed for the day of redemption. Let all bitterness and wrath and anger and clamor and slander be put away from you, along with all malice. Be kind to one another, tender-hearted, forgiving one another as God in Christ forgave you. Therefore, be imitators of God as beloved children, and walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself up for us, a fragrant offering and sacrifice to God. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
But raise it up on the last day.
For this is the will of my Father, that everyone who looks on the Son and believes in him should have eternal life, and I will raise him up on the last day. So the Jews grumbled about him, because he said, I am the bread that came down from heaven. They said, is not this Jesus, the son of Joseph, whose father and mother we know? How does he now say, I have come down from heaven? Jesus answered them, do not grumble among yourselves. No one can come to me unless the Father who sent me draws him, and I will raise him up on the last day. It is written in the prophets, and they will all be taught by God. Everyone who has heard and learned from the Father comes to me. Not that anyone has seen the Father except he who is from God. He has seen the Father. Truly, truly, I say to you, whoever believes has eternal life. I am the bread of life. Your fathers ate the manna in the wilderness and they died. This is the bread that comes down from heaven so that one may eat of it and not die. I am the living bread that came down from heaven. If anyone eats of this bread, he will live forever. And the bread that I will give for the life of the world is my flesh. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise be to thee, O Christ.
I believe in
one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible. Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of his Father before all worlds, God of God, light of light, very God of very God, begotten not made, being of one substance with the Father, by whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven, and was incarnate by the Holy Spirit of the Virgin Mary, and was made man, and was crucified also for us under Pontius Pilate. He suffered and was buried, and the third day he rose again according to the scriptures, and ascended into heaven, and sits at the right hand of the Father, and he will come again with glory to judge both the living and the dead, whose kingdom will have no end. And I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified, who spoke by the prophets. And I believe in one holy Christian and apostolic church. I acknowledge one baptism for the remission of sins, and I hope for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come.
Thank you. peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Our text for today is taken from the Gospel just read from St. John chapter 6, especially verse 35. Jesus said to them, "I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me shall not hunger, and whoever believes in me shall never thirst." That doesn't seem like such a crazy thing. It doesn't seem like something that should tick them off. And yet it does. Jesus says, "I am the bread of life that comes down from heaven." And the Jews that are there are enraged because he says this. Why? Why does this evoke such a feeling? God reveals himself in miraculous ways. In the Gospel of John, especially, Jesus goes through this series of I am statements, each one that points to some aspect of who God is and what he does for us. I am the bread of life. I am the good shepherd. I am the way and the truth and the life. With each one of these, he points out and kind of draws them in to recognize that God is there for them every step of the way. In fact, that statement, "I am," is really the basis of the name of God himself. So every time Jesus says, "I am," what he's really saying is, "I am God. I am the Son of God in the flesh who comes to give my life for the salvation of the world." The trouble for us, of course, is that the way that God reveals himself sometimes kicks us off. Sometimes the way that things work out in our lives, sometimes the way that God is at work in and through our lives is not the way that we would want it. After all, God's favorite way of working is through weakness and lowliness, through the backwards, the unexpected. God loves to take things and turn them on their ear, turn them upside down and inside out, so that we can see that he is the one that satisfies the desires of every living thing. He's the one that stretches out his hand. It's kind of like getting a new tooth. Stay with me here. That is, in order for the adult teeth to grow in, you've got to lose something, right? And that losing, that process is painful. It can be painful. And yet it is there precisely so that something greater can come in along the way. Now, we get another example of this in the Old Testament today. This wonderful episode with Elijah and Ahab and Jezebel. Elijah has been confessing the faith, speaking the truth to Ahab and Jezebel, and they do not like it. In fact, to the point where they are going to kill him. "May the gods do to me what I should have done to you if I fail to bring about your destruction." Elijah runs away. He goes and hides, and his statement from God, or his statement to God, his prayer, is one that we can all recognize when things are not going as we expected. "It is enough, O Lord. Take away my life, for I am no better than my fathers." Our temptation when things do not go as expected, our temptation when things are tough, when God is at work more hidden than we would like, our temptation is to say, "That's it. I'm folding in. Take my life now, Lord. Things just aren't going to get any better." That is always our temptation, because that is Satan trying to draw you away from trusting in the one who gives himself to you. But remember what God does for Elijah. The angel wakes him up and gives him bread and water and says, rest, for the road is too hard for you. He rests, he eats, he does it again and again and again for 40 days. So God's solution for that weariness that Elijah had, the weariness that may be in your soul and in mine, the weariness of, I don't know how this is going to work. I don't know how God is going to continue to do what he promises. God's solution for that, if you can believe it, is food and a nap. I want you to reflect on that for a minute, because it is kind of funny, I know, but it is absolutely the truth. God knows you better than you know yourself. He knows your struggles, he knows your trials, he knows your needs, he knows your weaknesses. He knows the idols that you have. He knows everything about you, and one by one pulls those idols away so that you may trust in him once again. And in place of that idol, he gives himself. Because he also says, come to me, all you who labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. What God promises to do is to be that rest for you. To be that very food and drink that you need to be refreshed and to live and to move on. God gives himself to you in this way so that you can remember, first of all, who you are. I am a child of God. God feeds me from his hand every single day. But also so that you can remember how God works. That God works through these ordinary, backwards, upside down things that happen so that you may trust in him alone. Like a gift. God knows when we need to eat and to drink so that you might live. God knows when you need a nap. God knows when you need rest for your weary soul. He gives it again and again and again. That's who God is. That's what he does. It is what he always does for you. In Jesus' holy name. And now the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keeps your hearts and minds in true faith to life everlasting. We rise and sing the offertory.
Presence and take my life.
peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the pure proclamation of the gospel throughout all the world, that Paul's teaching in Satan's lives would be thwarted, and that many would be drawn to the Father through his Son, Jesus Christ, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our congregation and all congregations in our circuit, district, and synod, that they may flourish and thrive, be strong witnesses to their confession of faith, show mercy on account of God, and live together in unity of doctrine and love for the neighbor, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For pastors, especially those suffering from conflict, burnout, or depression, that our Lord would give them strength and courage through the example of Elijah and all who have gone before them, bringing them comfort through the forgiveness of sins and the promise of everlasting life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For all families and homes, that one generation may tell to the next the wonderful works of God in Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the nation, that all may live in harmony, neither suffering from want nor fearing from danger, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the sick, including Joanne, Liesl, Jim, Eric, Darla, Gary, Jill, Gina, Lorene, Deb, Lori, Tammy, Bob, Tom, Wayne, Pat, Kathy, Tom and Joanne, Tiffany, Renee, Robbie, Demetrius, Bruce, Fred, Neil and Helen, Judy, Andrew, Rick, Jim, Irma, and David, that they would never doubt that God hears their prayers, and for all others who suffer from any kind of hardship, that the Lord would relieve their pain and provide for them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For those who mourn, that they would be comforted by Jesus' words that he is the bread of life, and anyone who eats of this bread will live forever. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For all who receive Christ's body and blood this day, that reconciled to each other they may rejoice to receive the Lord's forgiveness through this precious gift, be strengthened in times of doubt, and be nourished in body and soul. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Father of our risen, ascended, and glorified Lord, who has promised that those who believe in Christ as the true and living bread will never hunger nor thirst, by your Holy Spirit, keep us steadfast in faith. Give us grace to live out our baptismal lives in repentance and forgiveness, and keep our eyes ever focused on the life that never ends, knowing that you will raise us up on the last day, through the same Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up unto the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. That we should at all times and in all places give thanks to you, Holy Lord, Almighty Father, everlasting God, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who having created all things took on human flesh and was born of the Virgin Mary. For our sake he died on the cross and rose from the dead to put an end to death, thus fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify your glorious name, evermore praising you and saying,
Thank you.
come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
By your Holy Spirit, that we may be enabled constantly to serve you
Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Today will be their last Sunday at Holy Cross. Beloved in the Lord, in holy baptism you became members of the Holy Christian Church. Pastor, for 10 years you carried out the Lord's calling as shepherd of the flock in this place by delivering his gifts through our Lord's word and sacraments to the members of Holy Cross. Catherine, you and family have lifted up pastor's hands, supporting this ministry in many ways. Our Lord's gifts of word and sacraments have also sustained and nourished your entire family during your time here at Holy Cross Lutheran Church. As we bid you farewell and Godspeed, hear the words of the Apostle Paul. I thank my God in all my remembrance of you, always in every prayer of mine, for you all making my prayer with joy because of your partnership in the gospel from the first day until now. And I am sure of this, that he who has begun a good work in you will bring it to completion in the day of Jesus Christ. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Lord God, Heavenly Father, we give thanks that you have so faithfully nourished both this congregation and the Peperkorn family in the communion of your church. Bless, protect, and defend them as they depart from this place to serve the Missouri Synod in Fort Wayne, Indiana, where Professor Peperkorn will teach and help form future pastors for the church. Preserve this family in the confession of your name and in loving service to others. Keep us in fellowship with all your saints and bring us at last to the joys of your heavenly kingdom. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Go in peace and joy. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you.
Please stand.
The Lord be with you.
And with my spirit.
Bless me, the Lord. Make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace.
Amen.
Thank you.
Some college.
I love college.
college basketball.
Take care.
College.
No,
have fun.
Exactly. God's blessing. Alrighty, absolutely. One Martin Luther Drive. That's my address.
By the way, I just broke the line.
Yes.
I'll
see what I can do. If she said it's okay, then it's okay. I try to follow orders when I can.
I'm doing jobs.